Ain't nobody gonna fucking bunt. The fucking aliens are back. Episode number 49. We're gonna get into it. We gotta bang some of this shit out, but first, we got to do this date in history because we got aliens we're dealing with today. Again, aliens. I'm telling you, it's out there, but we're going to get into it. History has its eyes on me. On the 26th day of the month, June, it's July. Stupid ass. On this date in history, in July 26th. I looked up June 26th for some stupid ass reason, so we're going to restart on that one. History has its eyes. Upon the calendar, the 26th of July, in the year of 90, under the summer sky, an act was signed, its impact profound, echoing justice's call, a clarion sound. George H.W. Bush, with a signature swipe, brought forth a change, a new archetype. The ADA, or Americans with Disabilities Act, a law ensuring fairness, that's a fact. In workplaces, schools, and public space, equal access became law, a fairer space. Rights for all, regardless of ability, a landmark in our quest for equability. Equability. Never heard that word. Equability? No, it's equability. No matter the hurdles or physical plight, each citizen deserves equal right. So on this day, in the heart of the summer, a step towards justice that's far from a bummer. Let's honor this day and the ADA. On this July 26th, we proudly say, in the history of America, a crucial date when we chose inclusion over hate. So this date in history, Americans with Disability Act was signed by George H.W. Bush. Shout out to the Handy Capables. But anyway, like I said, we got a big breaking news. Not really breaking news. Every day you hear something about aliens, but we're going to get deeper into it. So this dude, former U.S. intelligence agent David Grusch, confirms under oath that aliens exist. Here's the clip.
Do you believe our government has made contact with intelligent extraterrestrials?
Something I can't discuss in public setting.
Okay, I can't ask when you think this occurred. If you believe we have crashed craft, stated earlier, do we have the bodies of the pilots who piloted this craft?
As I've stated publicly already in my News Nation interview, biologics came with some of these recoveries, yeah.
Were they, I guess, human or non-human biologics?
Non-human, and that was the assessment of people with direct knowledge on the program I talked to that are currently still on the program.
Do you believe our government has made contact with intelligent extraterrestrials?
Something I can't discuss in public setting.
So this guy testified before Congress under oath to a committee that's in charge of looking into this shit because all these whistleblowers and people that aren't officially whistleblowers but are coming out from working at the government or working for corporations or industries and three-letter agencies that have recovered aircraft and all this stuff have been coming forward for decades at this point. And they formed a committee and said, we have to look into this because it's getting fucking weird. There's no way all these people are lying. And the government's like, yeah, well, we're not going to tell you. So it's starting to come out a little bit. So this guy, David Grusch, has claimed, like you just heard, that the U.S. government led a covert UFO program spanning multiple decades. Grusch testified at a congressional hearing that during his tenure at the U.S. Department of Defense, the DOD, where he led the analysis of unexplained aerial phenomena, or UAPs, he came across evidence suggesting the existence of non-human beings, like you just heard in the clip. He said non-human biologics. Why not just say fucking aliens, man? The congressional hearing was initiated in response to Grusch's allegations in June that the government has been harboring extraterrestrial technology. Grusch reiterated these claims, stating he was privy to multi-decade UAP crash retrieval and reverse engineering programs, access to which was subsequently denied to him. The proceedings drew worldwide attention, sparking speculation that the U.S. is concealing evidence of alien life and technology. Grusch, who lodged a whistleblower complaint in 2022, said he was tasked with probing what military and defense agencies knew about aliens and their craft. However, he alleged being barred from secret government UFO programs. That's where the fucking skeptics are going to be like, well, he actually never saw him. He's just testifying that he knows people that did see him, which I could see because that's obviously a hole in the fucking story. The whistleblower voiced his hope that his actions would ultimately lead to increased transparency. His initial allegations that the federal government was withholding evidence of extraterrestrial technology from Congress led to a significant uproar, prompting the Republican-led Oversight Committee to initiate an immediate investigation. Co-leading the investigation is Republican Congressman Tim Burchett, who has been vocal about the U.S. possessing evidence of technology that, quote, defies all laws of physics, end quote. However, he tempered expectations of the hearing, stating that there will be little to no green men, or there will be no, quote, little green men or flying saucers, end quote. Despite the attempts to downplay the matter, Grusch's testimony claimed that the U.S. had indeed recovered alien beings. He stated that these biologics were non-human, echoing his previous public claims. In past media interviews, Grusch was more detailed, claiming the government have massive football-sized alien craft and bell-like craft recovered from Benito Mussolini's government in 1933. He was more guarded at the hearing, citing security concerns. Again, another red flag. The run-up to the hearing was marked by allegations. The reason it's a red flag, before I keep going on, is now he's fucking under oath. He starts lying and shit. It's going to be trouble. So it's a little different when you're in front of a camera and you're not under oath. But now that he's under oath, he's starting to, you know, dumb down the story. So another red flag. And I like alien. I believe in aliens, but I can see why people don't believe this dude. Anyway, the run-up to the hearing was marked by allegations from Burchett and his co-investigator, Anna Paulina Luna, a Republican congressman from Florida that had been stonewalled by federal officials. After the hearing, Burchett seemed satisfied, finding Grusch's claims about the recovery of non-human bodies credible. However, the Pentagon has dismissed Grusch's claims of a cover-up, stating that there is no substantiated information supporting the existence of programs involving the possession or reverse engineering of extraterrestrial materials. While these events have stirred excitement and speculation, some caution against reading too much into the testimony. Grusch hasn't seen the alleged alien craft himself. His claims are based on, quoting, extensive interviews with high-level intelligence officials, end quote. Say he's never even seen these fucking things. He just knows people that has. I know people that have seen aliens, and they're fucking retarded. Ooh, can't use that word. Skeptics point out that allegations of the government hiding information on UFOs has been made in the past. They argue that the U.S. government maintaining such a profound secret for decades without any substantial leaks or documentary evidence coming forth is dubious. They further express skepticism about the government's ability to effectively keep such high-impact secrets. The saga continues, leaving us in suspense about the reality of alien life and technology. So this dude, while he was on News Nation, right? It's not Newsmax. Newsmax is the crazy one. I think it's News Nation. Anyway, when he was on there, he's like, yeah, football-sized crafts and yada, yada, yada. And then all of a sudden, when you get sworn in and you get caught lying to Congress during an investigation, the consequences are a little more heavy than just telling a exaggerated story on the news. So that's where it's not that I don't believe this guy. I think he was probably on a super top secret, high level intelligence, because he's an intelligence official. That's not being denied or anything. Like, he probably was in the know about some crazy shit going on, but he wasn't in the room where it's going on. You know what I mean? Like, he's not. If he came out and was like, no, I'm in that fucking room. I see all this shit every day. There's little green men running around. It's men in black. You know what I mean? Like, if he's hardcore giving details, when he went from News Nation saying football-sized aircraft and all this other stuff to non-human biologics, and I wasn't in the room, but I know people, I've interviewed people. It's like, dude, I've talked to people. I could find someone down the road from my house right now that's seen an alien. You know what I mean? Like, go to the bar. Go to Rudy's Bar and Grill in Patchogue, and you'll find someone that's seen aliens. Probably a couple aliens running around that place. You know what I'm saying? So I can see why skeptics are there, but I want to believe this guy. These intelligence people, like the intelligence crowd, intelligence analysts, they don't really deal in bullshit too much. That's not like their thing. They wouldn't be credible at that point. And launching a whistleblower complaint has consequences if it's caught that you were fucking lying about something. So for him to go all the way out, and he's older, I don't know, maybe he is trying to make a name for himself, but I like to believe that this guy is actually telling the truth and might have been right there where they're like, in that room was the aliens, but you're not allowed in that room. So maybe that is the case, but I guess we'll see. You know, aliens are aliens, and they're always interesting, but that's not what we're going to talk about all day today. Today is the Would You Rather on a Wednesday. We got two editions we can do. We can do the adult version, or we can just do the non-sexual version. So maybe we'll bounce in between both. We'll see what's going on. But we're going to get into it. So in the spirit of the game, I decided since there's two lists, let's just break them down. Five and five. Five sexual ones, five just more funny ones, and we'll go from there. So, leading off, you're going to want to put earmuffs over the children, because the first question is, would you rather only be able to have sex in your parents' house, or never be able to have sex at your place again? I'm going to go with the sex. So I guess sex is only happening in my parents' house, which, I mean, I've grown out of that phase as an adult, as one should. But not having sex ever again, that sounds miserable. So I'm going to have to go with just at my parents' house, which would be miserable in general, living 3 hours away. You got to go drive 3 hours to have sex, and you're sweaty from the car ride. You know, like you back sweat because sitting in a car for 3 hours. It's not as bad as 12 hours that I used to drive, but 3 hours in New York City traffic, still going to have a little moisture going on back there. So you're going to be kind of smelly from sitting in the car, and you're going to have to tell the girl to be like, yeah, meet me at my mom's in 3 hours. Traffic pending, you know? It's just going to be, you got to make it four, because you can't just walk in the door and be like, hey, we're going upstairs. You got to, you know, hey, ma, how's it going? Say hi to everybody. By the way, I'm going to be upstairs because I can't have sex anywhere because I played this stupid game on a podcast and now I'm stuck having sex here. So I'm going to go upstairs. See you later. Now, earmuffs off, an adult question, or not an adult question. This is not an adult question. So, would you rather be able to speak every language fluently or be able to play every instrument beautifully? Oh, man. See, like, both of those are, like, really cool things to do. However, if you could play every instrument, you're not around instruments that much. I guess if you could play every instrument beautifully, you would have more instruments around. But you can just drop not. You could just be speaking a different language whenever you want. So I think I'm going to go language. I feel like language is more useful, especially if someone doesn't know you could speak the language that they're speaking and they're talking shit. That's why I've taken up Spanish lessons. Shout out to Rosetta Stone, because when I got to my new base, the majority of my office is Spanish, and they would speak Spanish to each other. And they were mostly just speaking Spanish to each other. They weren't talking shit, basically. They were just kind of, because one kid, he hears it, he kind of understands it, but he doesn't actually speak it. He's not fluent. The one lady, she spoke Spanish, but no one else can really speak it or like conversate, I guess. So they weren't really speaking too much shit. They were just kind of saying jokes, I guess. But I don't know. I didn't learn it in enough time. So, but if you could speak every language and listen to it, that'd be fucking sweet. You go somewhere and you go to like a Polish, like little Poland, like a little Italy, little Chinatown, shit like that. And you just listen to these people talk and they don't think you can understand them, but you can. Or if you go to like a French restaurant with a female before you bring her home to your parents' house to have sex, you start speaking fluent French to the waiter. That'd be hot. Anyway, moving on. Sex one, would you rather have to role play during sex or never be able to role play again? I'm gonna go never role play again. Yeah, I could do without role playing. That'd be another weird one. I gotta show up to my mom's house with a suitcase. What's in the suitcase? I thought this was your bag. This is your bag of clothes. What's that bag for? And you're like, nothing. And it's got weird shit in there. It's you know, it's got a fucking clown suit and one of those fucking chickens that you squeeze and one of those fucking things. And you're like, oh, now we're just playing farmer's market upstairs, about to haul some ass. All right, moving along, because we're dragging ass right now. Would you rather be stuck on a deserted island alone or with someone you can't stand? Alone. I'm going alone. You know how annoying it would be to be with somebody that you cannot fucking stand? And I'm not talking like you just don't like them for a little bit. There's people that I cannot physically be around for more than like 5 minutes because they just bother the fuck out of me. And it's rare. It's a rare person because usually I'm easygoing. And if I just don't like somebody, I can tolerate them and I'll still be nice and I'll still, you know, go the extra mile to not be a dick, because tension, especially when you're out with a group of people, is just weird. But in that situation, and you're that rare person that I cannot fucking stand to be around, there's no way I'm going to survive on an island with you. So I'm going to go alone. Or you can go the sick route, go with that person, kill him, eat him. Probably a little problematic though. So, would you rather have a partner who talks dirty too much, or one who never talks at all? I think we had this question last week. I'm going to go with talks dirty too much, you know? I feel like every time I say something, I answer one of these sex questions, I finish this sentence with, you know, and like I'm winking, I think. It's one of those like, yeah, you know, I'm giving a little head nod, like, yeah, you know what I'm talking about, right? Talk dirty too much? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. You ever see that sick show, The Idol, with The Weeknd on HBO? It's got to be trolling. There's no way they spent that much money on the show. But that dude's like, oh, I'm going to spread your pussy out. And he says shit like that. And he's like, oh, we're having sex. And it's fucking weird because it's The Weeknd and he's a terrible actor. But yeah, if you're talking dirty, like, it's like, oh yeah, like, ooh, like, oh, put that Vaseline on your hand and then put the hand on the back of my neck and tell me how oily my neck is. I love oily necks. Now take that ball and I want you to put that ball in your mouth. Yeah, I can get away with it. I can do that. I'll be the talk. Yeah, talk dirty too much is fine by me. Number 8. Would you rather age from the neck up only or the neck down only? Ooh, age from the neck up only, neck up only, you know? Age from the neck up. Yeah, because I feel like if you're chiseled from the neck down, like you just have, I mean, I'm still working on it. I'm 35 and I'm still working on the chisel part. But like if you're running around looking like James Marsden, but the rest of your body's 75 years old. Yeah, if you look like prime James Marsden, like the Notebook James Marsden from that neck up, like, yeah, that'll only get you so far. Then you take off your clothes and you're just a 75, 80 year old person. Like, yeah, I think you're good. However, in my case, because I've been told I looked like John Hamm when I was younger, obviously. I've been told I looked like John Hamm. So in this case, I'm just going to look like an older John Hamm. So if I can keep the body of younger John Hamm, I'm good to go. That's the best of both worlds. So I'm going to go with keeping the body from the neck down, and then I'm just going to age and look like older John Hamm. So we're good there. Number 4. I don't know what question number we're on, man. I keep, because the two lists, so here's the thing. The lists are 1 through 5 sexual, and then they restart 1 through 5 for the adult. So I think we're on question, we did that one. So that's 1, 2, 3. And then we did 6. So this is question 7. Stupid. Would you rather lose your sexual desire but gain super intelligence, or lose your intelligence but gain an insatiable sexual desire? Man. I mean, you're going to lose your sexual desire when you get older. But at that point, you're already smart. You should be, or at least wise. I guess you're an old, wise man at that point. So I would rather lose my intelligence, because I don't think there's a lot going on upstairs anyway. And you're going to lose it anyway. Like, if there's not that much going on up there, like, I'm pretty smart, but I'm like average. Maybe slightly above. But if the average is 60% smart, I'm like 61%. Maybe on a good day, 64%. I'm not like, you know, pushing 75% smarter. So like, there's not a whole lot going up there above average, but not too far above average. So there's not a lot to lose at that point. So I'm going to go with the lose intelligence, but gain an insatiable sexual desire. Would you rather always smell like garlic or always smell like onion? Garlic. Easy. Next. Would you rather accidentally walk in on your parents having sex, or have them accidentally walk in you? We had this question last week. Walk in on me because I'm having fun. Would you rather have a rewind button for an embarrassing moment in your life, or have a pause button for the perfect moment? The rewind. So like, yeah, definitely rewind. Because if you make a decision, if it's a decision you're not sold on yet, you're like, I don't know what to do. I don't want to make the wrong one. This would eliminate all that, because you can make the decision. If you're like, oh, this sucks, you can just go back and rewind it and then change your decision and then go from there. I guess that would change like your entire future. So you might get stuck in like where you keep rewinding to get a different outcome. I guess that gets into like the predetermination shit we were talking about, deja vu. But yeah, I think I'd rather rewind, because you don't know you're in a perfect moment until after the fact, and you can't go back. It's not like you can pause in the moment, because you don't know it was a perfect moment until after. It's a pretty deep thought. But yeah, you don't really know you're in a perfect moment until after the fact. So the rewind button would be good, because then you could just replay the best moment. You can replay a perfect moment. Like, oh, that was a perfect day. Rewind it and do it again. Or you can rewind it and try it a different way. It might not be 100% perfect, but you know, you're like, oh, I wish I would have done that, and go back and change it. Definitely the rewind button. That's going to wrap up the Would You Rather. Hopefully the kids didn't hear too much crazy shit going on. We're just at the... Actually, we're pretty late. It's 28 minutes in. There was a lot of silence in here, though, that you won't hear because the editing that I do, the production level of this podcast is phenomenal. It's almost a masterclass on how to edit a podcast by yourself. From not knowing shit about editing podcasts up until about 3 months ago when I started this endeavor. So with that being said, we're going to get out of here. We all did the Would You Rather, so we're not going to do last question of the day thing. We're going to leave you with this, though. In the grand opera of the universe, we are but a druid.